Fifth grade, lesson 89, and this is on finding a square root. Okay. Now, what they're basically wanting you to see, Eli, is this little thing that looks like this. This is not a division problem.
Okay.
This is the square root symbol. What this means is what number two times when it's multiplied the same number twice equals this.
So,
what times what equals this? That's the same number.
So, can you put like a simpler one up there first?
Okay, let's try this. What times what?
Two times
two. Okay, so the answer to this, I would say, is two.
Yeah.
Okay, so two times two equals that. Okay, but this is how you would answer that. Square root of four is two.
You don't put it on top like a division?
No, no. Okay. You just put equals two. You could even go equals two. You're just showing that it equals two. You see that? All right. So, what I want you to see is this. The square root of 4 is 2, right? So, watch this. Do you remember me drawing that? Okay. There are one. Okay, let me change it up. Let's do it like this. So, 1, 2.
Yeah.
1, 2.
Is that a fraction?
Remember when I was doing 2 times 2?
Oh, perimeter.
Two? No, not perimeter. Area.
Area. Okay.
That was good. No, but you remembered that. That's good. Area. Okay? So, two times two is?
Four.
Four. Okay? And it makes a perfect square. That's why it's called a square root. Okay? So, watch this. We know that two times two is four. What is three times three?
Six.
Oh, that's plus.
Sorry.
Everybody does that.
Three times three, nine.
Nine. So, the square root of nine is, you're asking yourself, what times what equals this?
Three.
Three. So, watch if I drew it. Three times three is nine. It makes a perfect square. Okay, so not every number equals a square root. So, for example, watch this. What's the square root of 5? Does something times something equal 5?
No, not of the same.
So, that doesn't work. I can't even make a square because I don't even know what my two measurements are.
Yeah.
To have 5 right here. Do you see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Not every number will be a square root.
Okay.
Got it? Okay, now. So, the square root of 36 is what times what? And the answer would have been 6. 6 times 6. So my answer for the square root of 36 is 6. You know the cool thing is? You remember me telling you this the other day?
That's 6 to the second power.
Yes. Which equals what?
That equals 36.
Yes. These are opposites.
But, wait, what?
These will always equal the same thing. 6 times 6 is 36. And what is 36? Square root of 36? 6. It's kind of like 10 plus 5 equals 15. What's 15 minus 5? 10. You see how they're opposites? Plus and minus? You can.
But they equal the same? Wait.
No. Okay, so 10 plus. I'm using the same numbers.
Oh, that's.
And you that plus and minus.
Yeah.
Same thing here. I'm using 6 times 6, 36, and I'm asking you what times what equals 36. They're kind of opposites. That's the way they're seen. Okay? Yeah. Kind of the same thing with multiplication and division. What is 25? Let's do. What is 30 divided by 5? 6.
6, yeah.
Okay? What is 6 times 5? 30.
Yeah.
It's the same type. Those are opposites. Divide and multiply. Squares and square roots are opposites.
Yeah.
Okay? So if you know one, you know the other.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of thing. Okay. So I just kind of wanted to show you that. Okay. So if I asked you, Eli, the area of this square is 36 square centimeters. They show me a square, and they tell me that the area equals 36 centimeters square. They say, how long is each side?
Four. Like, okay. What do you mean?
How long is each side of the area?
So, the whole thing is, we'd have to divide it by four.
Close. No. Area, not perimeter. Area is length times
so
width.
So, we have to find out what's the thing that goes right outside of it.
Okay. So, what would equal 36? Because this is a square.
What's that two thing? That's square root.
Sort of, yes.
Isn't it?
Yes. Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that would mean to the second power, right?
Close.
36 times 2?
No. What times what equals 36?
Oh, we're doing that. Okay. 6.
Yes, okay. So they're asking me how long is each side if my square area equals 36. That means I have 36 squares in here.
Yeah.
What would this be and what would this be? What would this length of this side be, and what would the length of this side be? Six and six.
Yeah.
To equal 36. So I'd have six.
Yeah, I was
confused. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These would be 36 of these. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So they told me that the area was 36. So you needed to know, remember what this means, is blank times blank. A square is always equal. Same length, same width. Did you know that?
Yes.
A square always has the same length.
Okay.
Okay? Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, let's go to the next problem, okay? They want me to find this. Square root of 100.
50.
So I'm at close.
That's plus again.
That's right. Okay. So what this is saying is what times what equals 100?
10 times. Oh, it's got to be the same one.
No, you're right. What did
you say? 10 times 10.
10 times 10. Same number. 10 times 10 would equal 100. Very good. So the answer to this would be 10. Think you got it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now this one's a little bit more difficult, but it doesn't have to be. Stay with me. Okay, so we're going to do one side, then we're going to answer the other side.
We got to add that up, then do the square root of the what the adding is.
Very good.
And then
we're going to put equals.
Then we'll do that one and that one and then add them.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, so what is 16 plus 9?
16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
Okay, and what's the square root of 25?
Square root, what?
What's square root of 25? I'm asking you, what times what equals 25?
Don't tell me, 5.
Very good. So you can always start at 2. 2 times 2, 4. 3 times 3, 9. 4 times 4, 16. 5 times 5, 25. And you go, oh, okay, 5. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You can start at 2 and just keep going up. All right, now, this is our answer for this problem. Now let's go over here. What is the square root of 9?
3.
3. What's the square root of 16?
6.
6 times 6?
Yeah. That was 36, right?
Right.
Okay. This one is... I know it.
You do. Start at 2 and go up.
2 times 2 is 4. 3. Six times 6.
What's 2 times 2?
4.
3 times 3?
I was all the way up to 6 when I was.
What is 3 times 3?
9.
4 times 4?
16. 4.
4. Okay, so we've got 3 plus 4.
Okay. And then that would be 7.
7. So, 5 for this answer, 7 for this answer. What's this going to go in here?
7.
5. 7. Is this greater than, equal to, or less than?
Greater than, isn't it? And it'd be 6.
5 is greater.
7's the answer. That's what I'm saying.
No. This is the answer to this problem.
These things always go for the greater than, though.
Stop for a minute. This is the answer to this problem. 5. This is the answer to this problem? 7. 5 is greater than 7. 5 is equal to 7. 5 is less than 7.
5 is less than
7. The answer would be that.
That's what I was trying to say.
Yeah. Okay. Just making sure. Do you get it?
Yes.
All right. Let's say you had this problem. They tell me to compare this. Okay? Help me out. What's the answer here?
6.
6. What's the answer here?
What does that mean? That means 3. That would be 6.
No.
9.
9. So?
So it would be the
6 thing. Is...
It's the
less than thing. 9. 6 is greater than 9.
Less than.
Less than. Very good. You understand how to do it?
Yeah.
All right. That is less than 89.